Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am coming here today to give you a juice recipe for pain in the body. Doesn't matter if it is reproductive pain or joint pain or back pain or a headache. If you have pain, this is a good juice for you. So if you'd like to see how I make it, stay tuned. So here are all my juicing ingredients. All two of them. All I'm using for this recipe is lemon and celery. There is a popular juice recipe going around these days with celery juice, people drinking celery juice, and there are great benefits for celery juice, but I can't stand straight celery juice. So this is my rendition of the celery juice. It doesn't do the same thing that the popular celery juice does. What this does is it dissolves mucus and toxins out of the body and also alkalinizes the body. And so if you're struggling with pain, this would be the perfect juice for you. So what I have here is three small to medium sized heads of celery, and I'm just going to cut them. I rinse them. I don't like scrub them because they're organic, and I don't really care if there's a little bit of dirt on the celery because it's good for the microbiome, especially if it is organic celery. This juice is also good for the digestive system, so if you have digestive issues, it would be good to drink this juice. It's going to help with constipation, help clear out the backed up fecal matter and undigested foods that are in the small intestines as well as the large intestines. So, as you guys have heard me, if you want to heal naturally from any kind of disease, really, you need to make sure that you're cleaning up your gut. The other thing I want to say about this juice is it's pretty economical to make, depending on where you get your organic celery. I can get mine as cheap as $2 a bundle. Sometimes it's $180 a bundle. And for me to make 2 to 3 servings of juice for under $10 is amazing. And when I say servings, I'm talking about 24 to 32 ounce servings. That's a serving size to me. So most people can go and buy a coffee and spend almost $10 on it. So if you are saying that juicing is too expensive, really, you probably should think about like really the types of things you do spend your money on, and is that something that is helping you? Or if it's not helping you, then maybe redirect those funds into something that could be more beneficial for you. So that's how I combat the expense for juicing. I don't buy $10 coffees. I don't buy other things that are really expensive, like an expensive handbag that I really don't have any business with. I take that money and put it into my juice. It's just an example. I'm not saying you buy expensive handbags, but I'm just trying to make a point. So right here, I have 3 lemons. You can put more lemons in if you want. And if your lemons are organic, you can actually juice them with the peel on. You do not have to chop the peel off of the lemon. I just did that because I don't think these lemons are organic. And also, even though there will be more minerals and vitamins and more detoxifying if you leave the lemon skin on, it is a stronger juice whenever you leave the skin on. So just keep that in mind. If you can handle the skin, great. Some people will, like, if they have 4 lemons that they're putting into a juice, they might leave the skin on a couple of the lemons and then take it off some of the others because this juice can get really strong. But it doesn't need to be sweetened with apples or pears or anything like that. But if you find that this juice is not sweet enough, you can always add apples. If you add apples, it's not going to take away from the juice. It's still going to help you with the pain relieving, but it will be sweeter. But I think the juice is just fine, just the way it is. I know I'm always talking about juicing, but I'm going to tell you, juicing is one of those things that really does do a lot of healing in the body. Some people believe in it, some people don't. But I'm telling you, I think that it has been one of the biggest keys in my journey. So if you could just find time to juice, at least drink a juice every day. Like what I typically do is I'll juice enough for a couple of days for myself. So then I'm not in the kitchen juicing. Sometimes I will juice up to 3 days in advance. And that helps me to be able to carry out the juicing habit because I really am very, very busy. And all you do for this recipe is run it through, run all the vegetables and lemons through the juicer. And then you can either strain it, which this juice doesn't need strained from my juicer. It's not very pulpy, but some people like pulpy juices. So you just strain the juice or just drink it as is. You can drink it for breakfast, lunch, or dinner, or you can have it along with your breakfast, lunch, or dinner, or just sip on it all day long. Sipping on it is what I typically will do over a few hours, but you do what is going to be best for you. But if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for joining me. And if no one told you that they love you today, Chelsea in North Carolina loves you very much. Take care.